everybody, and you're welcome to join us here this morning in the chapel of Gonzaga College to celebrate our annual deceased past pupils mass. And it's an unusual setup, like a lot of things that we're doing at the moment. You'll be watching this recorded, and I hope that you find the comfort that you normally find from joining us in this celebration and commemoration of those members of our community who have passed, both recently and throughout the life of the college. So I'm going to hand you over now to Father Miles O'Reilly, SJ, who will celebrate our Mass for us this morning.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. And may the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. This is a very special annual Mass offered for all the deceased of Gonzaga College since its inception. All the past pupils, all the teachers, both men and women, all the Jesuits, headmasters, vice principals, administrators, staff, they're all remembered in this Mass, and may they all rest in peace. This is the first time in 70 years that we had to celebrate Mass on a webcam. So greetings and welcome to all of you who are looking in and partaking in through streaming. In remembering all the deceased who were part of our lives, we are grateful for all the ways that they blessed and enriched our lives. And we pray that God may remove from them anything that may prevent them from realizing their full stature in heaven. And we pray now for ourselves, that our hearts may be made open and receptive to God's goodness and mercy by acknowledging our need for God's forgiveness. So we pray. Lord, we pray for healing for any way that we have hurt others or ourselves or harmed needlessly your creation. Lord, have mercy. We pray for forgiveness for taking your place in judging others and ourselves. Christ, have mercy. Lord, we pray for the times we lost hope in you by forgetting that nothing is impossible to you. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. And let us pray. Lord, look kindly to our prayers. As you raise your Son Jesus from the dead, may our hope for the resurrection for our deceased brothers and sisters be strengthened and renewed. We make this prayer to Christ our Lord. Amen. Our first reading now will be read by Will Park, Will Sparks, present in the past reading.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The virtuous man, though he die before his time, will find rest. Length of days is not what makes age honourable, nor number of years the true measure of life. Understanding this is a man's grey hairs, untarnished life. This is ripe old age. He has sought to please God, so God has loved him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord is my shepherd.
second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. As for me, the hour has come. The time is here for me to leave this life. I have done my best in the race. I have run the full distance, and I have kept the faith. And now there is waiting for me the victory prize of being put right with God, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give me on that day. And not only me, but all those who wait with love for him to appear. This is the word of the Lord.
So I am the way, the truth, and the life. And no one can come to the Father except through me. That saying of Jesus has always puzzled me, always challenged me, because it seems so exclusivist. What about all those who never heard of Jesus? How are they going to see the Father if Jesus is the only way? And what about the other world religions? Are they all just a dead loss? Do they have no value in bringing people to the source of life, God? So maybe my problem was that I've been interpreting this passage in the wrong way. Maybe there's another way of interpreting it. Maybe what Jesus meant by it is, the way that I live my life is the way. The way that I lived my life is the truth. The way that I lived my life is the life. So what is the way that Jesus lived his life? He allowed the Holy Spirit, which is unconditional love, for the healing and well-being and flourishing of the whole world, to be the principal guide in his life. So all his teachings, all his miracles, all his living, his death, and his resurrection were all oozing with unconditional love. They were all incarnating unconditional love. So what Jesus is saying is, this is the way to have life and to have it to the full. To allow unconditional love flourish in your life. Our baptism alerts us to the fact that we're built that way. That by grace we are born, just like Jesus, with the capacity for unconditional love. It's what makes us children of God. But the troubles and the traumas of life can so easily distract us from this capacity and disconnect us from it. Jesus is saying in today's gospel, don't let this happen. Don't let your heart be troubled. Don't let yourself be defined by fear and anxiety, or by bitterness and resentment, or by grief or loneliness or despair. Trust in me and trust in God, that you have in you the power of the Holy Spirit, the capacity to love unconditionally. In this way, in this spirit of love, if we follow this spirit, it connects us to God the Father. It leads us to God the Father, the source of existence, to God consciousness. And we're all sharing in that God consciousness. So we need to slow down and be still more often in our lives and listen to the promptings of the Holy Spirit in the depths of our being. It is there we shall feel connected to ourselves, to one another, and to those who have gone before us. We're all works in progress towards making unconditional love thematic in our lives. We will have reached our full stature when unconditional love becomes who we are, expressed in our own unique way and in our unique circumstances. And this is what Jesus wants for us. As he said again in today's reading, I will return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Represent those in each year group that have passed. and we will remember them now by name. Father Paul Andrews, SJ. Alberta Alvarez Toledo. Father Tony Baggett, SJ. Mr. Brendan Banks. Connor Barrington. Brother Jim Barry, SJ. Peter Barry. Brendan Bastable. Shane Bastable. James Bates. Peter Paul Bloom. Harry Boland. Tim Baumeister. John Boylan. Richard Brennock. Father Richard Brennan, SJ. Michael Brennan. Father Joe Brennan, SJ. Father Joseph Brereton, SJ. Barry Reswell. Declan Broderick. Hugh Brown. Mr. Frank F.X. Buckley. Mrs. Mary Burke. Vivian Candy. Ms. Sheila Carey. Paul Carney. Pascal Carney. Justin Carroll. Brian Carroll. Colin Carty. Jared Casey. Anthony Clare. Neil Clark. Richard Clark. John Cooney. Frank Corr. Michael Cunahan. David Doyle. John Cross. Father Paddy Grow, SJ. Mr. Fred Cull. Barry Cunahan. Leslie Daly. Father Joseph Dargan, SJ. Paul Davis. Killian de Valdertha. Michael de Courcy. Donald de Pere. Father Hubert Delaney, SJ. Father Frank Doyle, SJ. Mr. Jerry Duffy. Mr. Patrick Duffy. Father John Dunn, SJ. Lothar Endos. Tom Eustace. Leo Evans. Mrs. Kitty Evans. John Feeney. Kevin Feeney. Paul Feary. Alexis Fitzgerald. David Fitzgerald. John Fitzgerald. Father Kieran Fitzgerald, SJ. Paul Fitzpatrick. John Fitzpatrick. Fiacra Flanagan. Mr. Michael Green. Mr. Tom Halpin. Barry Halton. Father Timothy Hamilton, SJ. Hugo Horan. Gerard Hosey. Father John Hughes, SJ. Mrs. Marilyn Hurley Bimstein. Father John Hutchinson, SJ. Paul Jackson. Father Joseph Kavanagh, SJ. Brother James Kavanagh, SJ. Father Edmund Keane, SJ. Father Joe Kelly, SJ. Pierce Kent. Joseph King. Brian Kirby. David Laffin. Father Kevin Laheen, SJ. Andrew Landy. Father Henry Lawler, SJ. Father Billy Lee, SJ. Jerry Lloyd. Finbar Lloyd. Mr. Frank Lunnigan. Mr. Benny Miner. Mark McEnroe. James Kevin McGurse, James Mackin, Father John Mackin, SJ, Connor McGuire, Lawrence Mahan, John Matthews, Peter Matthews, David Mullen, Michael McCarthy, Mr. Noel McCarthy, Mr. Austin McCurtain, Gordon McDonough, Fergal McDonough, Edmund McGill, John McGill, Dave Brian McGovern, Bernard McGrath, Kieran McKeown, Brian McLaughlin, Reginald McMahon, Paul McNally, Mr. Daniel McNeilis, Hugo McVeigh, Father Patrick Marr, SJ, Mark Miller, Juan Martin Neely, Brother Hubert Monaghan, SJ, Father John Moylan, SJ, John O'Hearn, Father John Mulligan, SJ, Brian Murphy, Father David Murphy, SJ, Dennis Murphy, Father Edmund Murphy, SJ, Father John Murphy, SJ, Michael Murphy, Edward Murphy, Brother Patrick Nolan, SJ, Donal O'Higgy, Colum O'Brien, Francis O'Brien, Father Kennedy O'Brien, SJ, Donaha O'Buchala, Owen O'Buchala, Father Patrick O'Connell, SJ, Mr. Dara O'Connell, Father Charles O'Connor, SJ, Peter O'Connor, David O'Connor, Martin O'Dea, Mr. Tom O'Dea, Angus O'Donnell, Mr. Eunan O'Donnell, Connor O'Duffy, Liam O'Farrell, Mr. Cahill O'Gara, Coleman O'Higgins, Mrs. Esme O'Higgins, and Tahar Dermot O'Leary, SJ, Father John O'Leary, SJ, Dermot O'Reilly Highland, Jonathan O'Reardon, David Owens, Arthur Plunkett, Kieran Pollan, Andrew Quinlan, David Ray, Mr. Father John Redmond, SJ, Father Stephen Redmond, SJ, Mr. Brian Regan, Christopher Robson, Father Redmond Roach, SJ, Dermot Rodden, Mr. Norman Ruddock, Michael Ryan, Garrett Shannon, Brian Shannon, Mark Slattery, Tony Spallum, Mr. George Stokes, Peter Sutherland, Brother Jim Sutton, SJ, Mrs. Kay Sweeney, Bernard Tormey, Father Joe Beale, SJ, Signor Edmundo Valdi, Frank Walsh, Killian Walsh, Patrick Walsh, Niall Walsh, Brendan Walsh, Leslie Webb, Jerry Whelan, Mrs. Joan Whelan, Brendan White, Father William White, SJ, Mr. John Wilson, McDara Woods. And now we're going to ask Connor to light candles now to commemorate those past pupils who have passed away in the last 12 months. And they are Matthew McQuaid from the class of 1982, Geoffrey McEnroe from the class of 1958, Dermot O'Brien from the class of 1963, Rory Daly from the class of 1959, Sean Bukala from the class of 1992, Francis Byrne from the class of 1960, and Andrew Bacon from the class of 2014. And we also remember anybody we're not aware of, and also all recently deceased family members of our community. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. December, it will be great for Dallas.
And now the special prayers of the faithful, remembering our deceased loved ones. Lord, be with us in this time as we walk through the valley of the shadow of death. Be near us this day as we remember, as we weep, as we give thanks for the person we have known and loved. Amen. So, Elizabeth and Connor, I'm going to come present today. Let us remember those whom we have loved in the rising of the sun and its going down.
We remember them in the blowing of the wind and in the chill of the winter.
We remember them in the opening of the buds and in the warmth of summer.
We remember them in the rustling of the leaves and the beauty of autumn.
We remember them in the beginning of the year and when it ends.
We remember them when we are weary and need strength.
We remember them when we are lost and sick at heart.
We remember them when we have joys we yearn to share. We remember them as long as we live.
We will remember them, for they are part of us. Bless you, Lord, and we thank you for this bread, which the fruit of the earth and work of human hands may become for us the bread of life. Through the mystery of this water and this wine, may we come to share in your life as you come to share in ours. We bless you, Lord, and we thank you for this wine. is the fruit of the vine and the work of human hands, may you come for us that spiritual drink. Lord God, we ask you to please with the sacrifice we offer you in humble and contrite heart. Lord, wash away our iniquities, cleanse us from our sins. And pray, brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice, yours and mine, may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
The Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, praise and glory to his name, for our good and of all his holy church.
Lord, favorably look upon our offerings, so that your departed friends, our brothers and sisters, may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we're all united, who lives and reigns with you forever and ever. The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of time may be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful people, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling place turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for us in heaven. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Lord, you are holy indeed, the fount of all holiness. Let your Spirit come upon these gifts to make them holy, so that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate this Eucharist. And the night he was betrayed, he took bread and gave you thanks. He broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Christ has died, Christ has risen, Christ will come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking in the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullest of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Dermot our Bishop, all the clergy and all your people. And remember all the past pupils of this school who have been called from this world. Grant that they may be united with your Son in a death like his, and also be one with him in the resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and to all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may come to be co-heirs of eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. And now we all rise together and we say the prayer that the Lord has given us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, where you live and reign forever and ever. And may the peace of the Lord be with all of you.
Amen.
We offer one another a sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace. And this is the Lamb of God, this is he who takes away the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. And may the body and blood of Christ be in us and all we love to life everlasting. Amen. The body of Christ and the blood of Christ. So those of you who are looking through the webcam, just you can enjoy spiritual communion with Jesus. When you said, listen, behold, I stand at the door of your heart, knocking. And if you open the door, I will come in, and I will share and dine with you and you with me. So you are kind of a spiritual communion with Christ.
When I am gone, when I am gone, release me. Let me go. You mustn't tie yourself to me with tears. Be happy that we had so many beautiful years. I gave you my love. You can guess how much you gave me in happiness. I thank you for the love each of you has shown. But now it's time I traveled on alone. So grieve for me for a while, if grieve you must. Then let your grief be comforted by trust. It's only for a while that we must part, so bless the memories within our heart. I won't be far away, for life goes on. So if you need me, call and I will come. Though you can't see or touch me, I'll be near. And if you listen with your heart, you'll hear all my love around you, soft and clear. And then, when you must come this way alone, I'll greet you with a smile and say, welcome home.
So let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that our departed brothers and sisters, for whom we have celebrated this Eucharist, may pass into ever higher dwelling places of light and peace in heaven. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless all of us and bless our world, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord and one another. Amen.